Okay, we're on a mini split today that it's probably been put in for a couple of years. It looks like it's been here maybe, I don't know, 4 or 5 years. We had some icing on the service valve on the small side, and you can notice what I want to show you is right here on the valve. You see where the icing starts? This is where the metering starts taking place. A lot of people call this the liquid line, but it's not. On mini splits, this is actually part of your evaporator. The metering starts here, and then it goes through the system, and this is actually part of the evaporator and not a liquid line like on a central system. So going over to the system, let me just open up my gauges here. Got it on 410A. Our pressures are 59.3. We want to see it way above that. I mean, it should be somewhere probably around 130, 140. And check your superheat. Superheat tells you everything you need to know. We're 67 degrees superheat, so that means we're not picking up anything from inside. So I'm just going to go ahead and add some Freon, and then I'll be right back and we'll check the superheat. Okay, I got some gas in it now. It took me probably about 10 minutes there. But the whole thing is the reason I even stopped it. It's because it takes a long time to put it in. You put in a little bit and you let it circulate through the system, and then you come back and put in a little bit more. If you dump it all in one time, get your pressures up to where you think they should be, and then just take off and don't watch it, then more than likely you're going to be overcharged. But anyway, it's blowing out good hot air in the front. Icing immediately goes away as soon as you do that. And let me just show you my pressures. They're still going to bounce around for a little while, and I'm going to sit here probably another 5 minutes. But I dumped about a pound of gas in it. Probably a little bit less than that. So it don't take much to make a big difference on these machines. But I said it should be somewhere around 130. It's 122. Superheat's right at 5 to 6. It's going to bounce around a little bit, but I don't want it any lower than 5. Typically, where I stop it at, it's around 5. Let it go back up to around 10 and try to keep it somewhere between 5 and 10 degrees. Depends on the temperature inside. Inside right now is like 65 degrees. They've got it cranked way down. But then again, this is, I think, about five-year-old machine. And looks like they did a good job installing it. Got line hide going up the wall. I think that's the Versatex Speedy channel. But did a good job. You know, if this machine was probably another couple years older, I would just say if it leaked down bad 2 times a year, easiest thing to do is just replace it. These things are so inexpensive, and once everything is here, it's a matter of just reconnecting lines and reconnecting the cables. I mean, gosh, in probably 45 minutes I could have a new machine in. So we're going to gas it up. I'm going to go around with some soap bubbles and just double check these fittings, because over the years the flares can expand and contract and start to leak a little bit. So I'm going to double check them fittings. If I don't see anything there, then we'll probably just let it go. And if it leaks down within this year, then we'll probably do something further. But in 5 years, a little bit of gas is not a big deal. It's very common for an air conditioner to start leaking over time. It's just a matter of when. It's not if, it's when on about all of them. But anyway, I gassed it up. We're just going to double check them fittings, and that's it. We're in good shape.